if there is anything, because Niliona Grace, like 4 or 5 days before she passed on in hospital, and even if she was not able to talk to me, she was lying there in bed, but Niliona, sura yake, she was at peace with God. Now, najua, Grace, I believe, ako kwa Mungu binguni. I believe Grace alienda direct. Kwa sababu huko uwezi omba mtu appointment. Najua kama ingekuwa ninatafuta appointment ya kwenda mbinguni, sisi tungefungiwa nje. Lakini kwa sababu Mungu alisema in John 14 verse 6. Kole Jesu, I am the way, the truth and life. Nobody will go to the Father but through me. If we know Christ, we know God. And we have a destiny, we have an appointment with God. That is a standing appointment. Ukisha kubali Mungu, direct appointment. You don't need to talk to somebody. You don't need to talk to me. You don't talk to my relatives. You don't need to talk to a member of parliament. You don't need to become a president to go there. You just need to have faith in God. And because of that, nilipanga leo, tuimbe munisaidie tuimbe, omwavane IC. Tuimbe a song number 223. Wawale wanaenda IC. Sijui kama inaimbo kwa hiyo kanisa ingine. Kagila ye gigasi kondi tap chesu ye tun konya koken ako it petu ne mai kesu ke ketu tosi en gipsen gweta ki chek cheki gondo ye gigure gai nai ke mi tuku ye gigure gai nai cho ye gigure gai nai cho ye gigure kainai cho ye gigure kainai kemi tukum tun gongeto spiche gigo peke Kristo kitaya ke tuitosi aki chege tensoe tun gete pie en gipsengwe tagie tim denyo akoi ye gigure kainai kemi tukum ye gigure kainai cho ye gigure kainai cho ye gigure kainai cho ye gigure kainai kemi tukum onge ot kumye ye tim denyo akoi kowe kine ongi bartelap ke ye nyi en chamye Yegi Gesu sebe nyoye monya mako mi poishe Ake kure kai naike mi tuku Yegi kure kai naicho Yegi kure kai naicho Yegi kure kai naicho Yegi kure kai naike mi tuku. So I want to ask, when the names are called, when the role is called up yonder, to the one of grace. That is important. And if the list will come today, to the one of grace. We should not wait to say, again tomorrow, again the day after. And that's why, honestly, I think we need to heed to the call that the president told us, and the deputy president, and the other leaders, including Raila Odinga, that it is time. Maybe we should change our politics. It is time, maybe we embrace each other. It is time, at least we change the direction of how we lead people. Because for so too long, we've become so much full of ourselves, fighting over protocol, fighting over where to sit, fighting who will speak last, fighting as to who is Bwana Mkubwa, who will be given siren, who will not have siren. We've become so focused on things that in reality, when you lie there, they mean nothing. They mean absolutely nothing because we never returned anything to society. Grace, one day, nilikuwa kwa deputy president. Grace akakuja, I was still waiting for reception. Nangojea Grace aingie. Nangojea time yangu ya kuwa na deputy president ifika. Grace akafika. Akaambiwa na watu wa kuorganize. Sasa wewe, baada ya Murkomen, kuna mtu mwingine, alafu wewe. Akasema pana, my appointment cannot wait. My appointment is not for my issues.
Now Grace went straight to Deputy President's office, Akafungwa Mlango, and she cried. She didn't cry for her children, she didn't cry for herself, she cried for the people of Baringo South, because she believed in the people of Baringo South. Tukisema Grace was actually voted, even when she was in hospital bed, people never voted for the face of Grace, they voted for her actions. They voted for what she has done. And I want to challenge our leaders here. Ladies and gentlemen, what is important when we are making decisions about leadership is what are your deeds? What are your deeds? Deputy President, usiogope. Kwa safari yako, umeambiwa na bishop, umeambiwa na kila mtu, wewe utakuwa rais ya Kenya. Na mimi nikisema utakuwa rais ya Kenya, sio kwa sababu wewe ni mkalenji, sio tunatoka kwetu, na sio kwa sababu tunashare the same language. You have demonstrated, you know, ability to perform, and you have performed in a manner that we can only reward you to be the president of Kenya. And not because we love you, and you are not deputy president for Kalenji. You are the deputy president of Kenya. We cannot reduce you to come and pick a bonk between you na Murkomen, na Senator Mugine, na nani. You have been elevated to certain position because Christ said you can be in that position. And the Bible says all authority that is in the world, any person who is in leadership, is because God ordained. Rais Moi alitarauliwa na watu wengine. Akasema ajui kuongea Kiingereza, ajasoma sana. Wakati alitaka kuwa rais, wakaenda kutafuta atubadilishe katiba. Nasikia alifungiwa nje, alitafuta appointment hapo State House Kisumu, Nakuru, akapikwa kofi, akavumilia. See what that patience did. He became the president of Kenya for 24 years. Mwite, deputy president, memory. Memory akochani, mwite. If you, the Bible says in James chapter 2, if you become patient in our suffering, that suffering brings patience, and that patience brings character. You will be able to serve because you have been patient. So we relax. May not your story in Yelifanyika, but it's not for you to explain to this Ken. Niliona mbunge mungine, akikuritikula na kutusu pala. Where would you complain? You have not complained. Why is someone else trying to work so hard to explain? Why are you explaining? Deputy President hajakwambia ameumia wapi, amesema tu, these are challenges of life, and he will continue in that challenge of life. And I want to ask our leaders, let's just remain in that direction, tukue katika hiyo direction. Tuende tu pole pole, tuende pole pole. Wala tusioni neshane madharau, tusioni Grace, hata tukiwa hapa ulisikia Grace akisema mama yake alikuwa nani, baba yake alikuwa nani. What speaks for Grace, that's why I'm in Mochongoi today, is because Grace functions, Grace deeds are speaking for her. Not her heritage, not her relatives, not the people she knew. It is the things she did that are speaking to us today and says, Grace lies there, having served this country with commitment and passion and dedication. And I want to tell watu wa Baringo, mimi niko na nyinyi. Kama vile nilikuja hapa na deputy president tukakuja kulia hapa pamoja. Niko na nyinyi kwa shida, kwa tabu, kwa matatizo, kwa mazuri, mpaka tuhakikishe kwamba Kerio Valley imekuwa mzuri, Baringo imekuwa mzuri, sisi wote tukae kwa amani. As one leader from this region, I will work and I will ensure that we work together in a journey that is going to unite this country to move forward. I don't want to say so much. Speaker of our Senate, Senator Lusaka, alituma pole zake, tulikuja na yeye mpaka hapa, but because Deputy President alisema, I was talking kwa hii function mpaka ishe, akamwambia Lusaka to represent him in another function in western part of the country, that's why alienda huko, but he was within the vicinity. And I want to ask our leaders, my friends in the Senate, nataka kushukuru Gideon Moi, nataka kushukuru Senator Kiika, nataka kushukuru huyu wa Murang'a, asanteni kwa kunifanya, although president na deputy waliniongoza, lakini asanteni kwa kunisupport nikiwa majority leader kwa Senate. Na kwa hiyo niwaambie pia, mkitaka siku nyingine ukue kitu kingine, Biblia inasema asiyekubali kuongozwa hawezi ongoza. Let us all accept tuongozwe na watu wengine, ndio siku nyingine sisi pia tuweze tukapata nafasi ya kuongoza. Asanteni sana na Mungu awabariki. Thank you very much.